like I feel today, said I'm feeling tomorrow, just like I feel today, oh no. I'm gonna pack my suitcase and make my getaway. Oh, that St. Louis woman, she wears a diamond ring, oh no. She leads a man around, oh, of a bond string. I lord it, lord it, lord. I got to St. Louis blue, just as blue as I can be. That a woman got a heart like a rock in that deep blue sea. All them St. Louis blues I cannot lose.
About this crow, I had a crow. I raised him, got him out of the nest when he just about high feathered out. I had two. I had three. The rats killed one of them. And I traded off one for a pint of whiskey, and I kept the other one. And this one, I had him for 9 years. And he got so he could just call Hattie, that's my wife, and Bill, Hattie, that's his plain you call him. So Hattie's always reading true stories, one thing or another. And I had to walk about a foot and hit that little old red house up there across the field for dinner, you know. And I had old Jim. Old Jim had the cage just facing me. So he jumped up and down. Bill, here come Bill. Bill, I see the smoke fly out the chimney. Been reading all morning, didn't have nothing cooked at all. Me starving to death. I come out, I said, hey, you got nothing cooked? I couldn't get that stove burning at all. I said, all the morning they never got a fire started. No. I said, well, you know, I'll make out some bread or something. I'll get something, and you can cook me something for supper. So she moved old Jim on the far side of the house while he couldn't see me, you know. So that kept going on, going on, going on. So we went over to, her mother lived over to Chevyville, Kentucky over here. And we went over and left old Jim out one hot summer day. Left him from Saturday morning until on a Sunday evening, no water or nothing. We come back and old fella did about perish to death for water. And had to walk the spring from here down to the road. Then it was dark when we got in. Had said, old crow, said old Jim gonna starve to death. Said he wants to drink water so bad. I said, I got three bottles of beer. I said, he gonna either drink beer tonight or wait till morning comes. I opened a bottle of beer and poured some out in the cup and he run his beer down in plumb to his eyes. He drank and drank and drank till he flew up on the roof and then he hold it and spin over like a top, you know. Had to say, you've done killed him. I said, no, he just fell on his beer. He'd be all right. And then when he fell off the roof, on he squashed, so I was going to flop on the roof, and he couldn't make it. I got him and set him up on the roof, sit there behind me to spit over and fall off. I just left him off the roof, and from that day on, he loved beer, and so I had a little whiskey there, them little whiskey glasses, you know, little vials like that, you know. I put out some whiskey one day, give him a little taste of it. Didn't knock it too much. And I opened his mouth and took me a teaspoon and poured it down him. He got about half drunk, and then you just had our glass. He said, Jim, want a drink of water? No! Want a little piece of bread? No! You want a little shot? Oh, yes! And just popped his wings. And he drank till he got drunk. So one day, I had him over to Sparta where I go get my whiskey and beer at. I had him over there. And this guy of old cold distillery come in there, appetizing cold whiskey, and I had him in the back end of my car. He rode when I got ready to go somewhere for Glasgow. He flew in there, was ready to ride. So he was sitting on the back seat. I said, and the bartender told him, said, Bill Lovers, I got a crew out here that drank whiskey. He said, I don't believe it. I said, now I ain't got enough money to buy a half pint. He said, if that cold drank whiskey, said, I'll buy you a half pint of old crow whiskey if he drinks. I said, now he'll drink it. He'll be up there and told Gilbert, said, Gilbert, to give Bill Lovers a half a pint of Old Crow whiskey and get me a glass. Said, I'm going to drink this cold drink. He got him a glass. I went and got old Jim, had something on the counter. Old Jim walked up. I said, you want a little drink of water? No. Want a little piece of bread? No. You want a little drink of whiskey? Oh, yes, that's proper swing. I eased it up to him. He just drank that and just, Bill, I said, say Bill, 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 Bill. And that fellow told me out of his own mouth, said, your living's made. Said, you won't have to get another lick at nothing. Said, we just take to have an Old Crow convention up here at Frankfort. Said, if you bring him at Frankfort, and he drinks like he did down here, said, we'll take you to Europe on the Old Crow. Said, we sell whiskey over there, too. And said, we got to put your one of those red vests on, pair of red shoes, and that fiddle, and take that crow. Said, your living's unmade. He was 9 years old. And the dogs and the cats and the crow get out of the same pen, and had the little old dog come there, and where he come from, we just took up there and stayed there. And he was eating with that dog, and that dog snapped him through the head. At 9 years old, he lived about 3 or 4 days and died. Now, if I'd have had him, I'd been a rich black man now. I've been trying to get one. I ain't never had nothing ever since. I've been trying to get one. So that's the end of that. But I tell you, one thing, but he sure did love his bourbon, and he'd bourbon. And then after he would get that, you know, he would fluff all through his wings, feathers, you know. They said, how'd you take a bath? I said, Jim, I don't mind you drinking. I said, I'll be doggone if you're going to take a bath. And that's something I can't do. Yeah, he won't take a bird bath after he got what he wanted. You want the smell of it all over him. Oh, be.
I got the blue. I got the alky-alky hole in my blue. So long, whiskey, you can make me frisky. So long, highball. So long, gin. Oh, tell me when you come in back again. I got the blue. I got the blue.
I got the blue.
I got the alky-alky hole in my blue. Oh, so long, oh,
bye-bye.
You can make me goodbye. So long, highball. So long, gin. Tell me when you come in back again. This is an old one, way back yonder in the 20s, come out about kicking that thing. Shaking that thing.
Shake that thing.
I mean, shake that thing.
Come on and shake that thing.
I'm getting sick and tired telling you to shake that thing. Now, Grandpapa Johnson, he grabs Sister Kate. He super local sugar and jelly on that plate. I mean, shake that thing.
Shake that thing.
I mean, shake that thing.
Come on and shake that thing.
I'm getting sick and tired telling you to shake that thing.
Papa Johnson, he glass us to cake. He sugar like shaking on that plate. I mean,
shake that thing,
shake that thing.
I said, shake that thing.
I'm getting sick and tired telling you to shake that thing.
Oh, no.
Oh, no. Well, then, let me see. One minute, I'll think it up in a minute.
St. James Infirmary.
Oh, yeah, that's another good one. That's another good one. Let's see, Kevin.
Double eagle?
Oh, yeah. Here's one. Oh, that double eagle. That's a good one.
Hey, Bill, do you know what... Where does that name come from? You know who wrote that or
no,
what that's supposed
I didn't
to mean?
No, I didn't know.
A double eagle now. Was that a piece of money?
I think it is.
Maybe...
I'm not sure, but I think it is. Might have been a railroad.
Thank you.
that right in 1925. I never will forget it. He had a guy that drove a taxi all the time, and he'd drive this Model T back and forth over around the bottom over there. I'd been there many days, so he was taking a haul people if you're going to get him, take him over there. And I come to town one day, and so he said, hey, Bill, said, you ever drive a Model T? But I hadn't drove one, but I'd watched the rest of the boys drive. I said, if they can drive one, I can too, said myself. I said, yeah, oh, yeah, I can drive. I said, well, get in this here T-Tom, go down there and get me 5 gallons of gas and bring her back up here. I'll be ready to go. I went down through town, right back in there. Oh, he was just chuckle-lucka. I could hear him got the 5 gallons gas me. Come back in there, and he was buying with money then. He had that little chain, like, hung on his nose, just set up on his nose, little chain hung down his vest pocket. I said to myself, I'll shake him off if you get 240. He won't hang on that too long. So, be going down the road then. Then the first one come up with foot feet on, unless you had to fork up there, you know. The gas was walking on this side of the gas here. He told me, he said, now, bro, when you wanted to go fast, he'd reach up there and give her the gas. He said, don't have to do it, said, you got a foot feet. He said, put your foot down, you want to, then you see a bend or something, ease your foot off of it, and said, just cruise on along. I said, yes, sir. You ready to put up a hill? Said, mash down on it. Well, going on that grass road, it just as crooked as a rainbow. If you ever got it, I know you've never been down that road. I mean, we've been down there. A spring fell off that foot feed. They threw the ford wide open. The further it run, the faster it got. I kept trying to slow down. Somebody might look at me out of Connie's eye. I said to myself, don't look at me, because I can't stop it. So he come going down there. He said, William said, take your time. Said, you're going to run over something. I passed the 2 horse wagon, the hub just rubbed together as I went by, just about, yeah, the hub just rubbed together. He said, I done told you my last time to slow her down. I said, Mr. Manning, don't you know I can't stop this here car? Oh, no, don't you tell me you can't stop. I said, I can't stop. I've tried everything in here. I said, I can't stop it. It was running too extreme, been all changing tune. You know how they do. It was changing tune. Going down the road, that's if he turned here, I just made the turn that track, just come up on 2 wheels and went in there. And they had the roadblock down that way, couldn't get through that log chain stretch, 2 posts down there. Hit that log chain and got back up and tried it the first time, and the next time he hit it and bounced back up just like a gumball. Set the radiator back just like it broke out both headlights. I bent one fender down and the race rod just went up just like a bull. And the top let loose from the windshield and that back just like a buggy top. They throwed it plumb back. Oh, man, might have had a cigar around back that mouth. If he had hit the windshield and drove that cigar in his mouth plumb to the floor. You ought to see him trying to get that cigar in his mouth. done stuck in there. And I was trying to get out. He said, listen, your back boy, I said, you ain't going nowhere. He got me all up in his shirt because he bounced me up and down. You know, you said you smacked. You're on one side of the yard, turned there. He tapped me so fast I couldn't turn no. So that day from there, I never drove for 2 more years. But what I'd aim to do, I'd aim to make it to that bottom now and then run around in that bottom and run out of gasoline, you know. Because he had a mile of bottom right around and around in there. If I'd ever hit that bottom, I fell off that marks of hill that was straight down, but I hit that bottom, I'd have been sailing. I set sailing, and I'd hit that bottom. But from that day, this I never drove that. Well, that was 1926. I lived up yonder, right across the road, up there from them silos up there. And I never drove nothing until 1928. And I had one myself. I had one with leather posting in it, motorcycle spokes in the wheel, 2 big wings on each side of it, the top dead back. I used to go to New Liberty while all the girls were at New Liberty. And this clean house. They all to be riding on the fender, you know.
One more time. Thank you.
Which one was it?
Oh, that last one. Oh, that last, last go round. Oh, that last go round.
Missed one, huh?
I'll tell you what, just give more Santa Claus. That's a good one. See. Everybody ready? You think you so handsome? What makes you think you so hot? What makes you think you got something that no one else has got? And you call me spend all my money, then you laugh and call me old Johnny Claus. I'm telling you, babies, I'm through with you just because, oh, just because. Think I'll be lonesome, oh no. Someday you think I'll be blue. Someday you think I'll be foolish to sit and wait for you. And you call me to lose all my girlfriend, that's and call me old Sonny Claus. I'm telling you, baby, I'm through with you just because. I got it that time. I got it that time.
I imagine you did. What do you want to give them now, Bill?
Stormy weather.
That's a good one.
Stormy weather.
Doesn't look much like it today, and we could use a little.
No, we don't. We could use a little water today. You know, we must not be praying if the old master done forgot us, I believe. I need a little taste anyhow. In the sky, stormy weather. Since me and my gal aren't together, it keeps on raining all the time, it keeps on raining all the time. When she went away, the blue stepped in the bed.
would have got me. All I do is pray to be good Lord above to let me walk in that light once more. I can't go on. Everything I have in common starts on me weather. Me and my gal on together. To keep on ringing all the time, all the time. Keep on ringing all the time. Oh, just a little more practice. That's about all.
I don't know.
Just give him that Georgia animal.
Okay.
That's one of my favorite pieces. One of old Clayton back in Michigan pieces.
You're watching Telecable, Channel 6 in Lexington.